Hi there. Well, we're getting into autumn now, and things are looking beautiful in the Waitaki electorate. I haven't been down to Wanaka for probably about 2 weeks now, but Wanaka and Central Otago continue to be absolutely stunning in autumn. So if you feel the need to come down my way, boy, you'll have fun because it's beautiful and there's always lots to do. Of course, one of the problems with that is always freedom camping continues to be an issue down particularly my way, because I've got long stretches of beautiful scenic area and places where people can stop, and if they're not self-contained, some people can tend to leave their waste behind. It's a huge problem for us in the South Island, one that's not really recognised, I think, by city folk, because of course your problems are different. So I'm still determined to keep working with the Freedom Camping Forum. I'm also looking now at running a private members bill on freedom camping, so that's about to start going through the parliamentary process. I think that the issue with freedom camping is that there's no one single answer for this. So you can't regulate, or you can't pass a law and make people behave responsibly out in the environment, but you can do a whole lot of things. And I'm quite pleased that this government has done a whole lot of things. We've worked very proactively with Tourism New Zealand and the Freedom Camping Forum. I've attended, I think I've been to one of their meetings, and I certainly have talked to the director and receive the meeting minutes. So I follow what the forum do very closely. That's all the industry players get together and work towards solutions. Local authorities, of course, are working on bylaws, and I think the impact of placing a $40 instant fine on people is having a good impact on people who have been camping in areas without self-containment. So things are moving along, so I will do my little bit by introducing a private members bill. Hopefully it won't take too long to get through the House, because of course we've got the Rugby World Cup 6 months away, and that will increase the amount of tourism going around the South Island. So finally, that's really what I wanted to talk today, except I also want to talk about my plant, which I generally have sitting in the background. And I guess sometimes we sit here in our office in Wellington and things can get pretty heavy going, so I don't talk to my plant, I really don't, but I noticed a week ago that it was starting to look a bit sick, so it's been the subject of some attention recently. So I hope that the bugs that have been lying on the underside of the leaves, sucking away all the nutrients out of it, have now been exterminated, and my plant will continue to provide a backdrop and something for me to look at apart from papers while I'm sitting here in Parliament. See you next time.